Caribbean Community Theater. We ask that you take a moment now to turn off all cell phones and electronic devices, and please note that the photography and videography of this production is prohibited. There will be a 15-minute intermission between acts. Refreshments and raffle tickets will be sold in the courtyard, and the raffle drawing will take place at the end of intermission. Should you wish to recycle your playbill, simply leave them on your seat and we will collect them after the show. And now, Good Hope Country Day School presents Little Shop of Horrors.
On the 20th day of the month of September, in an early year of a decade not too long before our own, the human race suddenly encountered a deadly threat to its very existence. And this terrifying enemy surfaced, as such enemies often do, in the seemingly most innocent and unlikely of places.
What'd you break now, Krellborn?
Nothing, Mr. Mushnick.
So, she finally decided to come to work.
Oh, good morning, Mr. Mushnick.
What morning? It's 2 o'clock in the afternoon. Not that we had a customer. Who is customers when you run a flower shop on Skid Row?
I'm sorry.
Seymour, what is going on back there?
Very little, Mr. Mushnick.
Audrey, you better go back there and see what he's... Where'd you get that shiner?
Shiner?
Audrey, that greasy boyfriend of yours. Look, I know it's none of my business, but I'm beginning to think he's not such a nice boy.
You don't meet nice boys when you live in Skid Row, Mr. Mushnick.
I got these crafty potted for you, Mr.
Seymour! Look what you've done to the inventory!
Don't yell at Seymour, Mr. Mushnick!
Oh. Hi, Audrey. You look radiant today. Is that new eye makeup?
I'll get this cleaned up before any of the customers get here.
Oh, that ought to give you plenty of time. Look, God, what an existence I got. Misfit employees, bums on the sidewalk, business is lousy. My life is a living hell. You, urchins, off the stoop. It ain't bad enough I permanently got the winos decorating the storefront. I need you I need you three worthless ragamuffins completing the picture.
Oh, come on. We ain't bothering nobody, are we, Crystal?
No, we're not, Ronette.
You ought to be in school.
We're on a split shift.
Right.
We went to school till the fifth grade, then we split.
So how do you intend to better yourselves?
Better ourselves? Mister, when you're from Skid Row, ain't no such thing. The alarm goes off at 7, and you start a town. You put in your 8 hours for the powers that have always been. Till it's 5 p.m.
Then you go
downtown, where the folks are from.
I've always been poor. I keep asking God what I'm for, and he tells me, gee, I'm not sure. Sweep that floor, kiddo. I started life as an orphan, a child of the streets, here on Skid Row. He took me and gave me shelter, a bed, crust of bread, and a job. Treats me like dirt, calls me a slob, which I am. So I live
downtown.
That's your home address. You live
downtown.
When your life's a mess, you live
downtown.
Where depression's just status quo.
Down on Skid Row.
Someone show me a way to get out of here, 'cause I constantly pray I'll get out of here. Please won't somebody say I'll get out of here. Someone give me my shot or I'll rot here. Show me how and I will, I'll get out of here. I'll start climbing uphill and get out of here. Someone tell me I still can get out of here. Someone tell Lady Luck that I'm stuck here. She is sure with this well to get out of here. Hit the gutter farewell and get out of here. I move heaven and hell to get out of here. Got a hell of a lot to get out of here. Got a hell of a lot to get out of here. Got a hell of a lot to get out of here.
Look at that, 6 o'clock and we didn't sell so much as a fern. I guess this is it. Don't bother coming in tomorrow.
You don't mean...
You can't mean...
What? What don't I mean? I mean, that's it. Kaput.
No, you can't!
Kaput. Extinct. I'm closing this god and customer forsaken place.
Mr. Mushnick, forgive me for saying so, but has it ever occurred to you that maybe what the firm needs is to move in a new direction?
What Seymour's trying to say, Mr. Mushnick, is, well, we've talked about it and we both agree. Seymour, why don't you run out back and grab those strange plants you've been tinkering around with? You see, Mr. Mushnick, some of those plants Seymour's been working on back there, well, they're really unusual, and we were both thinking that maybe some of those strange plants prominently displayed and advertised in the window, well, it might attract business. Yeah.
I'm afraid it isn't feeling very well today.
Oh, there! Now, isn't that bizarre?
At least. What kind of weirdo plant is that, Seymour?
I don't know. I thought it was some kind of fly trap, but I can't find it anywhere in the books. So I gave it my own name. I call it Audrey 2.
After me?
Well, I hope you don't mind. You see, sir, if you place a strange and interesting plant in the window, like this, maybe...
Maybe what? Do you have any idea how ridiculous you sound? Just because you put a strange and interesting plant in a window doesn't mean people are gonna walk in and...
Excuse me, I couldn't help but noticing that strange and interesting plant. What is it?
Oh, it's an Audrey too! Oh,
well, I've never seen anything like it.
Oh, well, no one has.
Where did you get it?
Well, do you remember that total eclipse of the sun a few weeks ago? I was walking in the wholesale flower district that day. And I passed by this place where this old Chinese man, well, he sometimes sells me weird and exotic cuttings. Because he knows, you see, that, well, strange plants are my hobby. Seeing nothing unusual there that day. And I was about to, you know, walk on by. When suddenly, and without warning, there was this total eclipse of the sun! It got very dark, and then I heard a strange humming sound, like something from another world. And when the light came back, this weird plant was just sitting there. Just stuck in, you know, among the zinnias. I could have sworn I hadn't remembered it before, but the old Chinese man sold it to me anyway. For $1.95.
$100 worth of our very finest red American beauty roses.
Oh, here you go.
Thank you. Yes, sir. That is one strange and interesting plant.
Quick. Don't just stand there. Put that plant, what do you call it?
An Audrey 2.
Put that Audrey 2 in the window where passers-by could see. My God, I never believed it. My children, I'm taking us all to dinner.
Oh, I can't tonight. I've got a date.
With that same no good, Nick? I'm telling you, Audrey, you don't need a date with him. You need a major medical. He ain't a good, clean kind of boy.
He's a professional, Mr. Mushnick.
What kind of professional rides a motorcycle and wears a black leather jacket?
He's a rebel. And he makes good money. And besides, he's the only fella I've got. Well, enjoy dinner. Good night, Seymour.
Good night. Poor girl.
Are we still going to dinner?
You're not going anywhere, Krellborn. You're staying right here and taking care of this sick plant. How come he keeps fainting all the time?
Oh, I told you it's been giving me trouble. It just wilts like this. The Audrey 2 is not a healthy girl.
Strictly between us, neither is the Audrey 1.
If only I knew what breed it was, or what genus. But I can't find it anywhere in the books.
My advice to you is that you figure it out, and fast. Look what this exotic little beauty did for business.
I know.
So work, Seymour. Nurse this sick plant back to health. I'm counting on you.
I know.
You do?
I do.
So fix. Good night.
I don't know what to do for you. Mr. Mushnick and Audrey, they just met you. But I've been doing this with you for weeks. Grow and wilt, spurt and flop. Are you sick little plant? Or are you just plain stubborn? What does he want? What is it you need? I've given you sunshine. I've given you dirt. You've given me nothing but heartache and hurt. I'm begging you sweetly. I'm down on my knees. Oh, please grow for me. I've given you plant food and water to sip. I've given you potash. You've given me zip. Oh God, how I miss you. Oh pod, how you tease. Now please grow for me. I've given you southern exposure to get you to thrive. I pinch you back hard like I'm supposed to. You're barely alive. I've tried you at levels of moisture from desert to mud. I've given you glow lights and mineral supplements. What do you want from me, blood? Ouch! Damn roses, damn thorns, clumsy me. Hey, Dewey, look what I did. Hey, he opened up. I wonder what made you do that. I know it made you do that. Well, I guess a few drops couldn't hurt. I've given you sunshine. I've given you rain. Looks like you're not happy. Lest I open a vein. I'll give you a few drops. If that'll appease. Now please. Oh, 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 please. Wrote for me? No.
The genius who has developed a new breed of plant life hitherto unknown on this planet, Audrey 2. Just one last question, Mr. Krellborn. Do you feed it anything special?
Special? No. It's a secret formula, but it's not hard to come by.
I see. Well, thanks for stopping by.
I'd like to remind listeners of the Audrey 2 on display exclusively at Mushnick Grove Super Florist. Open 6 days a week, 10 to 6.
I can't believe it. It couldn't be happening. Pinch me, girls. It couldn't be happening. All this sun success coming out of the blue.
Do 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 do.
I put a sign up right in the front window. An advertisement right in the front window. Stop in and see the amazing new plant, Audrey 2.
Do 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 do.
And the really remarkable things that people they do.
Do 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 do. They sure do do.
Seymour, the twerp of a klutz, finally did something right. Audrey 2 drives him nuts. What a blessing this wonderful plant should exist. and to rake in the bucks for me hand over fist.
Well, how'd I do?
It was great, Seymour!
You got a second of the Wolfman!
But you didn't mention the address of the shop. How many times have I told you?
I'm sorry, I was nervous. Where's Audrey? She said she'd be here.
Forget about Audrey. I have 3 radio interviews lined up for tomorrow, and the Skid Row Herald Examiner wants a picture.
If I had a mother, she'd be so happy.
You're an overnight sensation, Seymour. Who'd have believed it? One day he pushed a broom, nothing in his news but gloom and doom. Then he lit a fuse and give him room. Stand aside and watch that mother blow. Explosion, bang, kerboom. Don't it go to show you never know.
Seymour was in a funk. He was number 0. Who'd have thunk? He'd become a hero, just a punk. He was a forgotten so-and-so. Then one day,
crash, kerplunk.
Don't it go to show you never know.
All the world used to screw him. Biff and Pow, now they interview him. And they clamor to put his remarks on the air. All the world used to hate him. Now they're starting to appreciate him. All because of that strange little plant over there.
Observe him, here's your chap. Everything is landing in his lap.
I just cut my hand and in a snap, something out of Edgar Allan Poe has happened.
Sam can snap.
Don't it go to show you never know. One day you're slinging hash, feeling so rejected, lightning flash. You get resurrected, make a splash. Now you reach the pink of your Simo.
And with the thunder crash,
crash, kerplunk, bam, kerboom, Sam can dunk, Sam can zoom.
Zowie, powie, holy cowie, ordered up a rainbow to go.
Wow, pal, look out below. Don't it go to show you never know.
Krellborn!
Genius.
And she ain't talk about George Washington Carver either.
Seymour?
Bingo!
Seymour and I are just friends, and besides, I could never be Seymour's girl. I've got a past.
And who amongst us has not?
Oh, I don't even deserve a sweet, considerate, suddenly successful guy like Seymour.
Mm-mm-mm. This child suffers from low self-image.
You have a point.
She have a problem.
I know Seymour's the greatest, but I'm dating a semi-sadist. So I got a black eye and my arms in a cast.
still that Seymour's a cutie. Oh, well, if not, he's got inner beauty. And I dream of a place where we could be together at last.
What kind of place is that, honey? An emergency room.
Oh, no, no. It's just a little development I dream of. Just a little daydream of mine. Not far off the interstate, and not fancy like Levittown. Just a little street in a little suburb. Far, far from urban Skid Row. Oh, the sweetest, greenest place where everybody has the same little lawn out front and the same little flagstone patio out back. And all the houses are so neat and pretty because they all look just alike. Oh, I dream about it all the time. Just me and a toaster and a sweet little guy like Seymour. A matchbox of our own. A fence of a real chain link. A grill out on the patio. Disposal in the sink. A washer and a dryer. And an ironing machine. In a tract house that we share. Somewhere that's green. He rakes and trims the grass. He loves to mow and weed. I cook like Betty Crocker. And I look like Donna Reed. There's plastic on the furniture to keep it neat and clean. In the fine soul-scented air, somewhere that's green. Between our frozen dinner and our bedtime 9:15, we snuggle watching Lucy on our big, enormous 12-inch screen. I'm his December bride. Oh, he's father, he knows best. The kids watch howdy doody as the sun sets in the west. A picture out of Better Homes and Gardens magazine. Far from Skid Row, I dream we'll go somewhere that's green.
Renovation for spiffing up and grooming, cause customers are flocking and business has been booming. We need refrigeration in our new improved display, so we're closed for renovation today.
Yes indeed, this is a shop you heard about on Channel 5 News. Yes, the LG2 is on display exclusively here.
We're closed for decoration, cause fortune has been smiling. So now we're due for painting, new plumbing and retiling. We'll make a ship-hip showplace of our little shop, and then tomorrow we'll be open again.
Aren't you finished yet?
I'm trying my best, but all these bands make it kinda hard.
You've been getting hurt so much lately!
I know! It's like every time I pick up the pruning shears, I slip! We're closed for renovation, for swabbing down and brooming, cause business has been thriving since Audrey 2's been blooming. The phones have not stopped ringing with the customers who say, another bunch of peonies, geraniums and anemones.
Take me
nuts
and
florida leaves. With Audrey's home deliveries
and catered bowls and COEs.
We're Club for Renovation today!
Seymour, did you get that order from Miss Shiva?
Mrs. Shiva?
Mrs. Shiva.
Oh, Mrs. Shiva. I forgot.
You forgot? How could you forget an order like that? They're our largest funeral account. A big family, huge, and they're dropping off like flies. I'm telling you, Seymour, if we lose business over this, you are finished.
You know, sometimes I think Mr. Mushnick's too hard on you.
Oh, I don't mind. After all, I owe him everything. He took me on the scooter home for boys when I was just a little tyke. Gave me a warm place to sleep. Under the counter. Nice things to eat, like meatloaf. And water. And floors to sweep, and toilets to clean, and every other Sunday off.
No, Seymour, I think you ought to raise your expectations. And maybe you could start with some new clothes. Oh, no offense, but with all the important interviews and photo sessions, a big, important experimental botanist has to look the part.
Oh, I'm a very bad shopper, Audrey. Oh. I don't have good taste. Like you.
Oh, well, I could help you pick some things out.
You could?
Sure.
You'd go shopping with me?
Sure.
You'd be seen with me in a public place, like a department store?
Sure.
Tonight?
Oh, I can't tonight. I've got a date, but I'd love to some other time.
Sure, I'll pencil you in.
Oh, gee, I bet you got a lot of dates now, huh?
Well, not dates exactly, but a lot of garden clubs been calling, asking me to give lectures.
Oh, gee!
Imagine me giving lectures.
Yeah.
I never even finished grade school.
Oh, that doesn't matter. You have life experience.
Well, some experience. I don't even know what it's like to fly in an airplane.
Oh, me neither.
Or eat a fancy dinner at Howard Johnson's.
Me neither.
Or ride a motorcycle.
Oh, it's no big deal. And besides, it's dangerous.
It is?
Extremely. Oh, gee, I better go fix my face. My date will be here any minute.
Me, ladies, but which way to 1313 Skid Row?
That information will cost you a dollar.
Hey, no problem. Here you go.
It's right over there. But if you're like the thousands of others flocking to see the Audrey 2, you're gonna have to come back tomorrow, man. The shop is closed today.
I'm not here to buy posies, girls. I'm here to pick up my date.
Your date?
You aren't by any chance talking about a girl with a black eye, are you?
And several other medical problems.
As a matter of fact.
Hey!
That's it! Whoa,
whoa, whoa, whoa, whoa, whoa, whoa, whoa, whoa, whoa. Ladies, please. I'm not a monster. Please stop. Truce. Haka. You want some nitrous oxide? My kind is a very nice kind, ladies. I'm not a monster.
So what would you call it?
I would call it... I would call it an occupational hazard.
Say what?
You see, ladies, my line of work requires a certain fascination with human pain and suffering.
Ooh, this stuff is great. Allow me to demonstrate. When I was younger, just a bad little kid, my mama noticed funny things I did, like shooting puppies with a BB gun. I'd poison guppies, and when I was done, I'd find a pussycat and bash in its head. That's what my mama said.
What did she say?
She said, my boy, I think someday you'll find a way to make your natural tendencies pay. You'll be a dentist. You have a talent for causing things pain. Son, be a dentist. People will pay you to be inhumane. Your temperament's wrong for the priesthood, and teaching would suit you still less. Son, be a dentist. You'll be a success. Ah, shut up, open wide, here I come. I am your dentist, and I enjoy the career that I pick. I am your dentist, and I get off on the pain I inflict. When I start extracting your molars, girls will be screaming like holy rollers. And though it may cause my patient's distress, somewhere in heaven above me, I know that my mom's proud of me. 'Cause I'm your dentist and a success. Say ah.
Ah.
Say ah.
Ah.
Say ah.
Ah.
Now spit.
Fine, thank you, but the shop's closed.
I'm not here to buy flowers, I'm here to... Hey! This must be that plant they're talking about on the news. What do you call it?
An Audrey 2?
Cute name. Catchy. Nice plant. Big.
Well, thank you. I raised it myself. Now, if you don't mind, I can't let you in here, you see, because
I hear they say it's some kind of new species or something.
Well, that's what they tell me, but you really can't be in here because, you see, the shop's closed,
no,
I can't...
Oh, Seymour, it's okay. Seymour, this is my boyfriend, Oren Scrivello. D-D-S.
Let me tell you something, kid. You say you raised this thing, right?
Right.
Well, if I were you, I sure as hell wouldn't keep it under a barrel in a skid row dump like this. This avocado here is your ticket to the stars. You can take it to any store in town and name your price. Hell, somebody make you a goddamn partner to get their hands on this.
Well, I'm very happy here.
Oh, yeah. Seymour's very loyal.
Somebody talking to you?
Oh, no. I'm sorry.
Sorry what?
Sorry, doctor.
That's better. I'm telling you, kid, this plant here is a big green gold mine. Get your ass out of this dump and take the plant with you.
What?
Mushnick Skid Row Florist. It's like a joke. You hear me talking?
I hear you.
He hears him.
Shouldn't we be leaving now? Oh, excuse me.
Excuse me what?
Excuse me, doctor. Excuse me, doctor. Excuse me.
You gotta train him, Esther.
Huh?
bikes outside and double park, but you think about what I said. I mean it. You think about it.
Sure. Sure, I'll think about it.
He'll think about it.
Audrey! You got the handcuffs?
Oh, they're right in my bag.
Then let's go.
He'll think about it. He'll think about it.
I don't like that guy, Mr. Mushnick. And you should hear the way he talks to Audrey.
God in heaven know the kid just said he'd mull it over.
Well, no wonder she looks unhealthy. It's enough to make you sick.
If Seymour left me, why then I'd be right back where he started, which was broken, starving.
Sweet and good and beautiful as she is, she deserves a prince, not a sadistic creep like him.
Close to bankrupt.
Well, what a louse.
Beset, befuddled, and bereft. That's what I'd be if Seymour left.
He's a disgrace to the dental profession.
Seymour!
Sir?
Seymour. How would you like to be my son? How would you like to be my own adopted boy? I never liked him much before, but count the cash that's in the drawer. I've got no choice, I'm much too poor. Say yes!
What for?
Seymour, I want to be your dad. I want to see you climbing up my family tree. I used to think you left a stench, but now I see that you were a mentor. I'm proposing be my son. Mushnick and son, sounds great. Three words with the ring of fate. So say you'll incorporate with me. A florist dream come true. Mushnick and his boy Chick U. What business will do for FTD? How about it, Seymour, be my son? Just say the word, I'll have my lawyer on the phone.
Now, Mr. Mushnick, don't be rash. You always said that I was trash.
Oh, I was joking.
Sir, I'm choking.
Use a physical expression of my pride, of the sweet paternal mysticos I've held pent up inside.
Gee.
So?
Well?
Well?
I?
You? Go ahead and say it, Seymour. Tell me that you will.
Well, gee, I'd really like to, but...
I'll hold my breath until...
Okay, you win, I'll be your son.
Hooray, I win, he'll be my son.
First that I'm touched, I really am. And when you reach age 83, I'll let you come move in with me.
You swear?
I promise.
What a son.
Mushnick and son, that's that. Officially, I'm your brat. Consider the matter closed and done. Now to the world, let's stick our senior and junior stick. Through thin and through thick. Through sloppy and slick. So come kiss me quick.
Please don't make me sick.
Mushnick and son.
Son, I'm his son. Sudden changes surround me. Lady Luck came and found me.
Thanks a million for making the magic you do. Thanks to you, sweet Petunia, Mushnick's taken
a junior. And someday when I own this whole shop, I'll remember I owe it to you. Aw, Chewy. Who cares if I've been a little on the anemic side these past few weeks? Well, sort of, I've had a few dizzy spells, a little lightheadedness. It's been worth it, old pal. Look, Chewy, I'm a little hungry. I'm gonna run out of Schmedrick's and get a bite to eat. Oh boy. Here we go again. Look, Chewy, I haven't got much left. Look, just let me heal a few more days, and then we'll start on the left hand, and then—
FEED ME!
I beg your pardon?
FEED ME!
Chewy, you talked. You opened up your trap, your thing, you said—
FEED ME, Crowborn! FEED ME NOW!
I can't.
But I'm starving!
Oh boy, look. Maybe I can squeeze a little out of this one.
I need some food!
I know, but you can't get blood from
More! More!
I haven't got any more! What do you want me to do? Slip my wrist? Look, how about I run down the corner and pick you up a nice shot sirloin?
Must be blood.
Ooh, that's disgusting.
Must be fresh.
I don't want to hear this.
Feed me.
Does it have to be human?
Feed me.
Does it have to be mine?
Feed me.
Well, where am I supposed to get it?
Feed me, see more. Feed me all night long.
That's right, boy. You can do it. Feed me, Seymour. Feed me all night long. 'Cause if you feed me, Seymour, I will grow up big and strong.
You eat what, Audrey 2? Let's face it, I want to keep on feeding you. Kill people?
I'll make it worth your while.
What?
You think this is all a coincidence, baby? Bust sudden success around here? Your adoption papers?
Look, you're a plant, an inanimate object.
Doesn't look inanimate to you, punk. If I can talk and I can move, who's to say I can't do whatever I want?
Like what?
Like the lift pair. I'd like to see with everything your secret greasy heart desires. How about a Cadillac car? Or a guest shot on Jack Parr? How about a day we head to Lamar? You're gonna get it.
Well, no thanks, Chewy. Kind of you to offer, but
how'd you like to be a big wheel? Dining out for every meal. I'm the plan to make it all real. You're gonna get it. I'm your genie. I'm your friend. I'm your winner's slave. Take a chance, just feed me in. You know the kind of eats, the kind of red hot treats, the kind of liquor sticky since I come on, Seymour, don't be a putt. Trust me, your life is truly Waffle King Tut. Show me a little initiative, look at them, but you're gonna get it.
I don't know. I don't know. I had so many strong reservations. Should I go and perform mutilation?
Come on, you'd have nothing till you met me. Who will it be? Money? Girls? One particular girl? About that Audrey. Come on, think it over, pal. There has to be someone you can idiot real quiet like and get me some lunch. How about the room at the Ritz, wrapped in velvet, covered in glitz? A little nifty gonna clean up those zits if you get it.
She had like a Harley machine, tooling around like I was James Dean, making all the guys on the corner turn green.
Go get it!
If you wanna be profound, ain't it really gonna justify? Stop and think it over, pal. A lot of folks deserve to die.
Wait a minute. That's not a very nice thing to say.
But it's true, isn't it?
No. I don't know anyone who deserves to get chopped up and fed to a hungry plant.
Mm-hmm. Sure you do.
Stupid woman, what a friggin' scatterbrain.
I don't
want to hear it. Get the hell in there and get the goddamn sweater, you dizzy cow!
Yes, Doctor! Go right away, Doctor!
Come on, move it! You stupid woman, who forgets the friggin' sweater? Got it, your stupid head weren't screwed on! Go, move!
If you want a rationale, it isn't very hard to see. Stop and think it over, pal. The guy sure looks like plant food to me. The guy sure looks like plant food to me. The guy sure looks like plant food to me. He's so nasty, treating her rough.
Smacking around and always talking so tough.
You need blood, he's got more than enough.
I need blood, he's got more than enough. I need blood, he's got more than enough. So go get it!
I guess it's me, Dr. Scribello.
Do you have an appointment?
No. Seymour Crowborn, we met yesterday.
Oh, yeah, you're the guy with the plant.
Right.
And the band-aids?
Right.
And the gun.
Right.
So, why are you pointing a gun at me? Seymour?
I...
Hey, you're not nervous about seeing the dentist, are you?
No, I'm not nervous.
It's only gonna hurt a little.
No, I'm not here to get my teeth examined.
Of course you're here to get your teeth examined. Say ah.
No.
Say ah! Oh, jeez, kid, your mouth's a mess. You've got cavities. You've got plaque. You're impacted. You're abscessed.
I am.
You need a complete oral examination. And we'll start with that wisdom tooth.
No!
We'll just rip the little bugger out of you. What do you say, Seymour?
I gotta go.
There's always time for dental hygiene, Seymour. Yeah. Have you ever seen the results of a neglected mouth? Look, Seymour, this could be you.
It could.
Unless I take immediate action. Let's get started.
Wait. Aren't you gonna use Novocaine?
What for? It dulls the senses.
But it'll hurt.
Only till you pass out.
What's that?
That's the drill, Seymour.
It's rusty.
It's an antique. They don't make instruments like this anymore. Sturdy, heavy, dull. This is gonna be a challenge. Whew. This is gonna be a pleasure. I'm gonna want some gas for this one.
Gas?
Nitrous oxide.
Oh, thank God. I thought you weren't gonna use any.
Oh, Seymour. The gas isn't for you. It's for me. I want to really enjoy this, and I find that a little giggle gas before we begin increases my pleasure enormously. In fact, I'm going to use my special gas mask. Just relax, Seymour, and I'll be with you in a moment.
Now, do it now, while he's gassing himself to a palpable stupor. The timing's ideal and the moment is super too ready and fire and blow the sick bastard away. Now, do it now, just a flicker of pressure right here on the trigger and Audrey won't have to put up with that pig for another day. Now, for the girl, now, for the plant, now, yes I will. But I can't.
Boy, Seymour, I am flying now. The things we're gonna do to your mouth. Boy, I think I've had enough of this stuff. I'll just take the mask off now and... Hey, Seymour, guess what?
What?
It's stuck.
What?
The mask, it's stuck. I can't get it off. Jesus Christ, I could asphyxiate in here. Hey, Seymour, give me a hand, will ya?
Well?
Well? Well, Seymour, I don't think you understand. Don't be fooled if I should giggle like a sappy, happy dope. It's just the gas. It's got me high. But don't let that fact deceive you. Any moment I could die. Though I giggle and I chortle, bear in mind I'm not immortal. While this whole thing strikes me funny, I don't know. Cause it really is a rotten way to go.
What we have here is an ethical dilemma. Unless I help him get the mask, if he doesn't have a prayer. Sure, the gun was never fired, but the way he been inspired, I can finish him with simple laissez-faire. What we have here is a tricky moral problem. Do I help him with a mask button, go flag of air? Couldn't shoot him when I tried, but the fates are on my side. I can off the guy by staying in the chair.
I should giggle like hyenas in a zoo. It's just the gas. It turns me on. But don't let that murk deceive you. Any moment I'll be gone. All my vital signs are failing because the oxide I'm inhaling makes it difficult as hell to catch my breath. Are you dumb? Or hard of hearing? Or relieved. My end is nearing. Are you satisfied? I laughed myself to...
Death?
English-speaking son, please hold.
$5,000 for the African violets. $2,000 for the baby blue eyes. The pink, the green, the yellow, and the purple.
Urchins, look, here's 10 apiece. Deliver these to the Dutch pavilion and these to the Japanese consulate.
You said it.
Audrey, I'm late for the lawyers. Tell Seymour to see that Corman gets his wolf bane.
I got those bribery delivered to Lizzie Taylor's suite, Miss Mushnick. She's real pretty.
And gorgeous gladolias. Seymour, can you help me with these bones?
Here you go, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am. Come again.
Flowers for a prom corsage.
Flowers for an entourage.
Flowers for a funeral home.
You can come to Andrew's Roman Catholic Church at 9th and Vine.
$40 hold the line.
First thing in the morning, they'll be there in the mink.
The Rose Bowl, Seymour the Rose Bowl. You know that big inflated estimate we wrote for the Rose Bowl. Well, it's the Rose Bowl. It seems they want to buy the flowers here for every single float.
Nick and son, please hold. It's just as the plant foretold.
Just a minute.
It's business like who'd have ever guessed.
Nick and son,
that was me, that was me.
The business
on
is
channel
doing.
Three.
So why am I feeling so depressed?
I get 2 tickets to the game. Michigan Sun, Fiddle's favorite florist.
7,000 boutonnieres, carnations, or the yellow roses?
Please, I've only got 2 rooms. Allergic to chrysanthemums?
Hollyhocks are hardier. Which one would your wife prefer?
Were you waiting long? 1 minute, sir. I'm sorry, and I'll get her for you.
Seymour, that reporter.
Her article finished yesterday.
She wants another interview. Said to bring the plant with you.
Audrey, it's that new account.
Sorry, that's the right amount.
Daisy's only come in white.
Sir, I'm too worn out to fight.
Sorry, those are out of stock.
Seymour, look. It's 6 o'clock.
Call back in the morning, will you?
Call back in the morning, won't ya?
Call back in the morning, can you?
Call back in the morning, can't ya?
Call back in the morning.
Oh, what a day, what a day! You mind locking up for me? I'm mauling.
Oh, 1 minute, Audrey. I want to show you something.
Wait till tomorrow?
It'll only take a minute.
Oh,
I've been shopping for a new wardrobe, like you told me to, and ta-da! What do you think?
I
You don't like it?
I don't know!
I'll take it off. I'll take it back. I'll burn it. Just don't cry. Please don't cry. Oh, look what I did. I only bought it to impress you. That's all I ever meant to do.
I'm sorry. I don't know what's come over me. I guess I've just been a little under the weather lately.
It's Orin, isn't it? You've been down in the dumps ever since his mysterious disappearance. You miss him, don't you?
Listen, I never felt so relieved as when they told me he vanished. It was like a miracle. Not to mention all the money I'd saved on Epsom salts and Ace bandages.
Well, then what's the matter?
Well, I feel guilty, I guess. I mean, if he was met with foul play or some terrible accident of some kind, then it's partly my fault, you see. Because secretly, I wished it.
Audrey, you shouldn't waste 1 more minute worrying about that creep. There's a lot of guys who would give anything to go out with you. Nice guys.
Oh, I don't deserve a nice guy, Seymour.
That's not true.
No, you don't know the half of it. A terrible life.
Audrey, don't.
No. I deserved a creep like Orin Scrivello. DDS.
And you know where I met him? In the gutter.
The gutter?
Oh, the gutter. It's a night spot. I used to work there on my nights off when we weren't making much money. I put on cheap and tasteless outfits. Oh, and not nice ones like this. Low and nasty apparel and I...
Audrey, it's all behind you now. You're a very nice person, and I always knew you were. Underneath the bruises and the handcuffs, you know what I saw? A girl I respected. I still do. Lift up your head, wash off your mascara. Here, take my Kleenex, wipe that lipstick away. Show me your face, clean as the morning. I know things were bad, but now they're okay. Suddenly Seymour, standing beside you. You don't need no makeup, don't have to pretend. Suddenly, Seymour is here to provide you with sweet understanding. Seymour's your friend.
Follow him blindly. He'd snap his fingers, and me, I'd say sure. But suddenly Seymour is standing beside me. He don't give me orders. He don't condescend.
Till forever. Tell me the bad times are clean washed away.
Please understand that it's still strange and frightening for losers like I've been. It's so hard to say. But suddenly Seymour.
Suddenly Seymour.
He purified me.
He purified you.
seems like the plot is thickening among my employees.
Please, Mr. Daddy?
Don't you Mr. Daddy me, Krellborn. Audrey, I wondered if you excuse Seymour and me for a little while. Perhaps you could visit your dentist friend.
That's not very nice, Dad. You know he disappeared.
Oh, he did, didn't he? Forgive me, boy chick.
Seymour? What's he talking about? Hey, what's he doing?
Why don't you run along like he asked, Audrey? I'll see you later. I'll call for you, if that's okay.
Of course it is. Good night, Seymour. Good night, Mr. Mushnick.
You're acting pretty strange, Pop.
I had a pretty strange afternoon, son. After my lawyer's appointment, I was called to the police station.
The police?
Yes. It seems they made a routine investigation on the disappearance of this motorcycle dentist. And when they did, they found a Mushnick Skid Row florist bag in his office.
Well, what's that supposed to mean?
Exactly what I asked myself, Seymour, until I started to notice certain things around here. Little red dots all over the linoleum.
I spilled some Hawaiian punch earlier. It's stained.
It's hard to keep things clean around here, Seymour. Especially when they only take out our garbage once a month.
What's that supposed to mean? Where are you going?
If you want something removed in a hurry, it's best not to dispose of it on Skid Row.
What are you talking about?
This! A dentist uniform!
He's got your number now.
I saw it last week and didn't think twice.
Knows just what you've done.
And the little red dot seemed innocent enough.
You've got nowhere to hide.
But then I catch you kissing the dentist's girlfriend.
You've got nowhere to run.
And it begins to look like a motive.
He knows your life or
crime. Once he's out of the way, you move in, right?
I think it's supper time.
I'm innocent.
Then how do you explain this?
A picture of a baseball cap?
Your baseball cap. The police found it in Scrivella's office, showed it to me, and asked if I could identify him.
Did you?
No. They don't suspect you at all, Seymour. But they don't know about the dots, the girl, the uniform.
He's got his facts all straight.
Just so my conscience will rest easy.
You know he's on your trail.
If you don't, I'll have to go tell them myself.
He's gonna turn you in.
So, will you come?
They're gonna put you in jail.
Okay.
He's SDA Prime.
Okay,
well, I'll lock up. For my supper time. Oh, come on, come on. Just think about all those offers. Come on, come on. Your future with Audrey. Come on, come on. Ain't no time to turn squeamish. Come on, come on. I swear on all my scores. When he's gone, the world will be yours.
Hey, let's go. Don't you want to collect the day's receipts? You can deposit them in the morning?
You put them in the safe, didn't you?
No.
Why not?
I forgot the combination.
It's thousands of dollars. Where is it?
In the plant.
In the plant?
I thought it'd be the safest place. No thief would ever been there, right?
So the money's inside the plant. How am I supposed to get it?
Just... knock.
Knock?
Seymour from uptown. He's been asking all over where can he find you. Is that him?
That's it, Mr. Bernstein.
Well, thank you, girls. Seymour Krub one, sweetie, honey, baby, pussycat.
Do I know you?
Well, of course not, but you're gonna be happy when you do. Seymour, sweetheart, dollface, bubbler. Hey, Seymour Krub one, your prince, you. My name is Bernstein, I'm with NBC. I came down here to convince you to do weekly TV show for me. Seymour Krubbon's gardening tips. You like it? I love it. For half an hour on Sundays at 4. TV's first home gardening program will make a mint and our ratings will soar.
They say the meat shall perish. You know the book doesn't lie. It's not a question of marriage. It's not demand, it's supply. So say the meat gonna get it. And you're a meek little guy.
I don't want to go today.
Oh, my darling, my precious, my sweet, sweet thing. So delighted to make your acquaintance. Cutie. Sweetness. Seymour. Baby doll. I'd like a word with you, lover. I'm sure you know me, the editor's wife. We want your face on the cover of the December 3rd issue of Life. Yes, the front of Life magazine. Now that's an offer we so seldom grant. We'll send someone down, let's say Thursday, for shots of you and your beautiful plot.
You say the meat shall perish. You know the book doesn't lie. It's not a question of marriage.
Life magazine! Oh my goodness, Seymour! You're gonna make it straight to the top!
How did you do it?
Here he is, sir, the amazing Seymour Krelborn, owner of the fabulous Audrey 2, America's largest and strangest unidentified plant.
So, this is Seymour Krelborn. We've been trying to reach you, baby. Have your lines been busy? Did you get our telegram?
I don't think so.
Well, it's a good thing I came down in person then. Pleased to meet you, kid. Skipsnip, William Morris Agency. Forget the cable we sent you. It's nice to meet me. The pleasure is yours. Now let my firm represent you. We want to book you on lecturing tours. College Campus Rotary Club. The kind of bookings my office can do. Show the plant, then talk, answer questions. It's educational, lucrative too.
My future's starting, I've got to let it. Stick with that plant and G, my bank account will thrive. What am I saying? No way, forget it. It's much too dangerous to keep that plant alive. I take these offers, that means more killing. Who knew success would come with messy, nasty strings? I sign these contracts, that means I'm willing to keep on doing bloody, awful, evil things. No! No! There's only so far you can bend. No! No! This nightmare must come to an end. No! No! You've got no alternative, Seymour, oh boy. Though it means you'll be broke again and unemployed. It's the only solution, it can't be avoided. The vegetable must be destroyed.
But then, there's Audrey.
lovely Audrey. If life were tawdry and impoverished as before, she might not like me. She might not want me. Without my plant, she might not love me anymore.
Is it a meek shall inherit?
Where do I sign? Right on the line.
Is that a question of merit?
That'll
the meek are gonna
tour. It's all about you. Just give me some peace and quiet. I'll tell them the truth.
Don't get cute with me. I made you so I could break you.
Go ahead. Break me. Do you think it's easy to live with the guilt?
Oh, cut the crap and bring on the meat.
If only you'd eat meat. If only you touch a mouse or flies, but no, you're so particular.
Come on, crab one. Feed me. I ain't eaten since Mushnik, and that was a week ago.
Look, just hold that one more night, will you? Life magazine will be in the morning to take our pictures.
Then you'll find me somebody.
Then you'll never be hungry again.
Feed me, crab on chow time.
I can't take anymore. Just stop
feed
swallowing,
me,
will
feed
you?
Me.
For God's sake, shut up. What's the matter with me? Don't you think I know it needs food? Don't you think I know it'll die if I don't feed it and soon? Don't you think I'm trying to think of some way, somehow, someone?
Seymour! What's the big deal with the little plant food? Now I think running the shop all by yourself is a little much for you. Now when did Mr. Mushnik say he'd be back?
Huh?
You know, in that letter you said he left for you. He said he was going to his sister's house in...
Czechoslovakia. Right.
Oh, yeah.
He could be gone a very long time.
Oh.
Audrey, can I ask you something?
Anything.
Well, suppose for a minute that there never been an Audrey too. Oh. That was just a nothing again. Nobody. Would you still like me?
Seymour? I still love you.
Then it's settled.
Wait, what settled? A gun!
And bullets! And rat poison! And a machete! Tomorrow night, after Life Magazine takes our picture, you know who bites the dust.
Seymour!
That's right. They'll snap our picture. We'll be famous. I'll take that TV job, and we'll live a nice, quiet, normal life together. No more night feedings. No more squalling for blood.
What feedings? What blood? Bullets? Knives? Rat poison? Seymour, you're scaring me.
There's nothing to be afraid of, Audrey. I'll take you to that little development y'all dreamed about. And once we're there, we'll live happily ever after. I promise. A nice little house, a nice little car, and no plants! No plants at all! I'll explain everything in the morning.
What?
Just go home, Audrey. Please,
what?
Go home.
No, I can't leave you in this condition.
Yeah, don't worry about me.
What?
Don't worry about anything. Circumstances.
Feed me!
I will not, so stop asking!
Feed me!
Look, how about I run down the corner and pick you up a pound of rare roast beef? Maybe that'll hold till Life magazine gets here.
Uh-uh, no way!
Look, it's my last offer. Yes or no?
It's better than nothing.
Fine, done, great, and don't think of getting dessert.
Couldn't sleep, I took a Somanex, but voices in my head kept saying, go to Seymour, talk to Seymour. I drank some tea, but still the feeling wasn't gone. Seymour, sweetheart, tell me, darling, what's been going on?
Hey, little lady, hello.
Who said that?
You looking cute as can be.
Is somebody in there?
Looking mighty sweet.
Seymour.
No, it ain't Seymour.
It's me.
Oh my God!
Your friendly Audrey T. This plant is talking to you.
I don't believe it.
Believe it, baby. It talks.
Am I dreaming this?
No. And you ain't in Kansas, neither.
Something's very wrong here.
Relax, go with it. Come on and give me a drink.
Oh, I don't know if I should.
Hey, little lady, be nice.
You just want water, right?
So do a drink, it's great.
Oh, your leaves are dry, poor thing.
No glass, need no ice.
I'll get the can.
Don't need no twister of
light.
And now it's our back time! Ha ha! Relax! Go at the doll, it'll all be easier! Go ahead, meet your dentist friend of Mushnik! They're right inside! Ha
ha ha! Audrey, no! Get off her! Get off her! Get off her! Get off her! Audrey! Audrey, are you all right?
Yes! No!
Don't die, Audrey. Please don't die. I need you.
You know, the plant said the strangest thing just now. He said that Mr. Mushnik and Orwin were already inside.
It's true. I did it. I fed them to it.
And is that what made it so big and strong? And you so famous?
I've done terrible things, Audrey. But not to you. Never to you.
But I want you to, Seymour.
What?
When I die, which should be very shortly, feed me to the plant so it can grow to give you all the wonderful things you deserve.
You don't know what you're talking about.
No, but I do. It's the one gift that I can give to you. And if I'm in the plant, then I'm a part of the plant. So, in a way, we'll always be together.
Wash my tender leaves. You'll smell my sweet perfume. You'll water me. and care for me. You'll see me bud and blue. I'm feeling strangely happy now, contented and serene. So don't you see?
Hula hoops?
Much bigger!
Every household in America, thousands of you eating! That's what you had in mind all along, isn't it?
No shit, Sherlock!
We're not talking about just one hungry plant here. We're talking about world conquest!
And I want to thank you!
You're a monster, and so am I!
Feed me!
The only thing I ever loved!
Too bad!
Take that, and that, and that, and that, and that, and that!
Give it up, Krillboy!
Never! Here, rat poison! Eat it! Eat it, eat it, eat it, eat it, eat it, eat
yummy.
It!
Give it up, small fry!
You may be tough on the outside, but in there, in that pod, I'll hack you to bits! Now open up! Open up, open up, open up!
Subsequent to the events you have just witnessed, similar events in cities across America, events which bore a striking resemblance,
consequence the events you have just witnessed. Unsuspecting jerks from Maine to California made the acquaintance of a new breed of flytrap and got sweet talked into feeding it blood. Just the plants work their terrible will, finding jerks who would feed them their fill. And the plants proceeded to grow and grow and began what they came here to do, which was essentially to eat Cleveland and Des Moines and Peoria.
They may offer you lots of deep thrills, fancy colors in Beverly Hills,
but whatever they offer you,
don't feed the plants.